Hi, this is Elizabeth, and welcome to Sube la Vibra. Today we are going to talk with Penny Pierce. Penny, welcome to Sube la Vibra. I am very excited because we will talk about your books, The Frequency and The Leap of Perception.
Hi!
Penny, can you talk about your book, Frequency?
Yeah, Frequency talks about the idea that the vibration of the planet is increasing constantly. Mm-hmm. And in fact, scientifically, they know that it's called the Schumann resonance. It's this, the vibration in the center of the Earth has been increasing very steadily over the last few years. But I think that when the Earth's vibration goes up, so does the vibration of our bodies, because we're made of matter mm-hmm. as well. Mm-hmm. And we're not sure what exactly causes this, but it has been happening. And we feel it. We feel this acceleration of time, you know, of everything just moving so fast now. And, you know, when I think about it as way back in the Dark Ages, you know, mm-hmm. we had finally the industrial age mm-hmm. where we had machines coming mm-hmm. together, you know, and mm-hmm. speeding things up for us. And then that expanded until we got computers, yes. right? And then computers launched us into the information age. So we went from the body to the mind. Mm-hmm. So we've been in the information age for a while. But that has speeded up so fast with the computers. Then we got the internet, and now we have so much information and data, we can't process it exactly. in the same way that we used to. And so now I've been saying that we're about to shift into the intuition age, which is where we go into spirit mm-hmm. and integrate spirit into our mind and our body so that they all become one unified thing. And that causes a shift of our perception, which is what Leap of Perception is about. So I'll save that for a little bit later. But frequency is, how do we deal with this increasing vibration of our body and of our emotions and of our mind? Because when we first notice it, we actually become uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. The body starts vibrating faster. We have symptoms. You know, we get yes. overheated. We start to get anxious. We start to feel we should be moving faster. We get heart palpitations. So many, I have them all listed in the book of mm-hmm. all the physical things that happen to us. Mm-hmm. But basically, we're starting to try to adjust ourselves from an old way of thinking and holding our energy mm-hmm. into a more fluid, you know, energetic way. And as that happens, our emotions change as well. You know, so you might become irritated, more angry, or just feel hopeless, like I'll never be able to keep up, you know, and you can mm-hmm. get depressed. And some people really, I mean, they really feel hopeless. They can commit suicide over not feeling like they can adjust their energy well enough. Other people get hyperactive, mm-hmm. you know, ADD and that mm-hmm. kind of thing. So there are energetic problems that we're seeing now that are just a result of this acceleration. So frequency really talks a lot about how to see yourself as energy. And I think one of the problems is that, you know, we're realizing everything is made of energy now. So we can raise our vibration from lower emotions into higher emotions, and we can choose to feel better, you know, by changing our vibration.
Penny, how can you explain your teaching to people that are excited about energy and everything that we are talking today?
Well, I think you can tell when you look at emotions, for instance, mm-hmm. that when you feel good, that's a higher vibration, actually. When you feel bad, it's a lower vibration. When you feel sick, it's even lower vibration. Yes. You know, and you can feel that spectrum of different emotions. But you can also, brain waves function at different frequencies. You know, you have beta, which is everyday consciousness. You have alpha, which is kind of as you start to go into meditation or sleep in a way as you make transition. You have theta and delta, which are the really long, slow, very high frequency waves where you can access other realms, you know, spiritual realms. You know, so there are a number of scientific ways that we can say, yes, we are vibrational.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
And, you know, if you have low emotional energy and low physical energy, you'll have low mental energy. You'll be negative in your thinking. You'll complain. You'll feel like a victim. You know, and all that ties together. It's like octaves in music. Mm-hmm. You know, low C, middle C, high C, they're all connected. So you change up to a higher frequency, your emotions and your mind change, and your body feels better. You can improve your health. You know, so many things are connected to vibration. And remember, I said before that energy and consciousness are just two sides of the same coin. Mm-hmm. So when you increase one, you increase the other.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
So we have the tools.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it makes sense, really, yeah. When you start to think about it.
Yes, yes.
And then you just need to remember that you can do it yourself, that the outside world is really does not owe you anything.
Yeah, that's
because actually, it's not even out there. Mm. That's you mm. at a larger, higher frequency. You are the whole world. There's no separation anywhere anymore. Mm. It's all one big, unified field of consciousness and energy. And that, you know, physics has been talking about that a lot. So when you start to realize there's no outside world, mm-hmm. that the outer, so-called outer world is just the physical manifestation of your inner thoughts. Yeah, that's mm-hmm. kind of amazing, because then you can't blame anyone for anything.
Yeah.
And you can't really feel like a victim, because, well, you can if you want to, you know.
Yes.
But why? You know, why waste your time? You might as well have fun creating things and, mm-hmm. and enjoying life.
And this is exactly what I see. Every day the people are more isolated, more with their phone, more in their own world.
I know.
And this is a big problem, because most of the people are addicted, no?
Right. Like, they want to blame it on somebody.
Yeah.
They don't want to have to. And it's not really work.
Yeah.
It's just a choice.
I have this book, Frequency, and it's great. Can you tell us an exercise of this book, Frequency?
I like the, there's one, an exercise in the book about working with diamond light. So you can imagine behind your back standing your own inner self made of diamond light. And he or she looks like you, but has no blockages, no fear. It's just pure light. So that's kind of like an image of the soul, really. But you let that person put their hands on your shoulders, and then you start to adjust yourself to that level of vibration. And diamond is very clear and high frequency. And you start to let it yourself adjust. Then they slide inside and step inside and sit down in you or stand in you and match up all the parts. Mm-hmm. Your brain has a diamond light brain inside of it. You know, your vocal cords have diamond light vocal cords. Your heart, every part, your bone marrow, your toes, all. Mm-hmm. And you go scan through your body, and that kind of like raises the frequency of all your organs, of your cells, to a level of ideal functioning. Mm-hmm. And then really you understand that. And you talk to that diamond light self and say, well, I don't really know what I'm doing, but you do. So please help me. You know, let me, you know, fall back into my optimal functioning so that I, you know, I can be my full self. Mm-hmm. And then you realize, wait a minute, I am that diamond light self.
Exactly.
I'm here now. Mm-hmm. And it's an amazing thing. And you can learn to do it very quickly, mm-hmm. almost within seconds, mm-hmm. if you practice it a number mm-hmm. of times. Mm-hmm.
That's wonderful. Thank you. Right now we have this wonderful book. I love it.
Yes. Leap of Perception.
Leap
yes.
of Perception.
Can you tell us what the Leap of Perception is about?
Well, as I was saying, transformation, I think, really has to do with the fact that we're changing from the information age to the intuition age, mm-hmm. from just left brain perception, which is the information age, to left and right brain perception, which is the intuition. So another way to say that is that the old way of perceiving the world is linear. Past, present, future, you know, mm-hmm. beginning, middle, end, where everything's in a line. You know, you have a timeline on things. You have plot lines. You have everything's linear, mm-hmm. right? Cause and effect.
Exactly.
Right. And that's the way we think about everything. You have to put in your dues. If you go to therapy, it takes you a long time to talk out your problems, go back into the past, get the thing, bring it into the present, clear it, you know. And that takes time. It's slow. Mm-hmm. Partly because here's me, here's my goal. There's empty space in between. Mm-hmm. I perceive there's empty space in between. So I have to cross that empty space with my willpower and my cleverness and my brain, and it takes a lot of energy.
Mm-hmm.
And it slows down the time between the thought and the reality. Now, because life has been speeding up so much, everything is actually coming into the present moment. Mm-hmm. We're getting closer and closer to having kind of instantaneous results. You think something and it happens almost right away, mm-hmm. you know? And I'm even seeing that healing is becoming faster on a lot of people. They clear a pattern and the body changes. You know, it's like it doesn't take a long time anymore. The more you come into the present moment with your full consciousness, the faster everything happens.
Mm-hmm.
So when we now, it's like the present moment to me is like a ball around you. What we're aware of right in this moment is our present moment, but it's a ball. You know, I can look at my window, I can, you know, feel my house, but that's in my ball,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
And you're in my ball right now, you know? You know, and that ball can be real small or it can mm-hmm. be really large.
Mm-hmm.
If I meditate, it goes way out and I yeah. feel a lot of, you know, consciousness and time and space. And in a way, the past and the future are now being swallowed up by this huge present moment.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's in the present moment.
Mm-hmm.
That means there's no more future.
Makes
so,
sense.
Oh, wow. So what is that? It means that past and future are frequencies inside your ball.
Mm-hmm.
Like if you put your, so the future is more like a potential reality that's a higher frequency of the one you're in right now.
Mm-hmm.
So if you raise your vibration mm-hmm. and encompass more of the ball, you'll have a different reality. And it could happen very fast,
that
just by
wonderful.
Placing attention.
Mm-hmm.
Attention is the key factor. Whatever you place your attention on becomes real. Whatever you take your attention out of dissolves and goes back into the field of energy. So we're learning a new way to materialize reality, which is very fast and easy, actually, too. It doesn't take so long.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, we're shifting out of the linear into the spherical reality, and also the holographic reality, which I won't get into because it's more complicated, but it's part of the spiritual reality.
Mm-hmm.
And that means the way we use our brain is changing.
Mm-hmm.
And we're starting to realize how interconnected everything is. It's all one big thing. Spirit and matter, your soul and your body, they're all together in one place.
Mm-hmm.
You know, everything's here in your ball.
Mm-hmm.
So if you put your attention on a new reality, like say one where you move to a different state or country with a different income level, with different, you know, computer or whatever,
mm-hmm.
You can keep your attention on that. And if you love that reality, it will love you back. And
so
it will come to you.
That means that the feeling is very important.
Yes.
Okay.
You have to make it real for your body. So what I do is I imagine little bubbles of mm-hmm. reality floating in my space.
Mm-hmm.
And then I take my imagination and I step inside those bubbles. And in there is a whole scene going on. It's a whole reality. Mm-hmm. I step into it and I pretend I'm in it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how does it feel? Does my body like it? Do I want to revise it a little bit,
mm-hmm.
change it a little so mm-hmm. I feel more comfortable? And I kind of fix it the way I like it. And then I go, I love this. I want this. And as you say that to the reality, it says that to you because it's connected, right?
Mm-hmm.
There's no either or. It's mm-hmm. both and. And so if you keep your feeling on it, it'll start to change. Your actual reality will change into that reality.
That's
which
wonderful.
is wild, you know, but
Yeah.
that's the way it actually works. Things, and the universe does a lot of the work. Synchronicities, new connections you need to, you know, make, just kind of, oh, your friend tells you about that article, or, you know, that thing on the internet, or this other person she knows, and things start to come together, you know. And it's not a lot of willpower, it's much more about joy.
Joy. A higher vibration, yes?
Right, right.
That is wonderful.
Right. Yeah. And so part of the Leap of Perception book is that I've outlined 9 different ways of attention skills, ways that we use our attention to be in the new intuition age reality. I explain them all very carefully, you know, how to do it.
That's great.
Yeah, and
it's
an important book, I think, yeah. actually, because it's
it.
Kind of a roadmap.
I love it.
For getting into it. Actually, that's the book that won 2 best book awards for science and cosmology. So, yeah.
Yeah.
And I think it was a little ahead of its time. It's starting to catch up now.
I think all of your books are a little bit ahead of the time.
They seem to have, you know, come in at a certain time, 1.5, 2 years, and then the next idea starts to come in. And, you know, so they further the explanation a little bit more. Maybe the world is at a higher vibration now, and so we get another piece of the puzzle coming in.
That's right.
You know, and so...
It's amazing.
Yeah, and then, of course, the last book is Transparency, which is take the next step. You
yes,
know,
last so. Step. So by the moment, let's say goodbye to Penny Pierce. Thank you so much for this interview, Penny.
You're so welcome.